It is our traditions, ceremonies, and rituals. Each small detail carries a deep layer of our ancestors' wisdom. It is our pride, our treasure, our national encyclopedia. Let's turn the pages of this encyclopedia together. The arrival of a new person into the family is a special event, and this event plays a significant role in the Kazakh traditions. At modern weddings, we can see the rituals which refer back to the period of nomadism. Why do the Kazakhs hide the future Kelin, daughter-in-law, behind shemolduk, curtain? What role do oil and fire play in the ritual of becoming a member of a new family? And why is the wedding always accompanied by the song Betashar? Answers to this and other questions can provide with a better understanding of the history of development and culture of the Kazakh people. In the recent past, the Kazakh engagement and marriage were accompanied by a series of rituals which could last several years. The first part of the marriage ceremony started in the Aul, village of the bride. The ceremony of your farewell to relatives was also held in that Aul. Then the festive caravan moved to the groom's Aul, where the wedding celebration was completed. The ceremony of the bride's arrival in the groom's house is called Kelin Tusru. It can be translated as Kelin, daughter-in-law, Tusru, to bring home. All relatives get prepared for this celebration. The one who first sees the approach of the wedding caravan and informs about it receives a gift which is called Tiyinsha. According to tradition, the bride does not enter house as soon as she arrives. First, she is left with the Zhengia, another elder daughter-in-law, near the house.
So,
when the groom's family together with the bride leaves the bride's awil, they put the curtain. It is a special curtain which is hung to hide the bride's face. The lady is the bride, but she is not wife yet. It is very beautiful curtain. The bride is hidden behind this curtain and brought to the groom's home. After arriving home, she sits in the separate room. If people want to see her, they come into this room. Mostly women come to see, is she beautiful or not, is she tall or short? Everyone is interested in her and wants to know what is she like. The curtain behind which the bride is hidden is called shemolduk in Kazakh. It is believed that shemolduk is designed to protect the bride from the evil eye. But scientists have another explanation of hanging the ritual curtain. All these actions are sacred. Why it is needed to perform such rituals? In fact, the groom's family, by opening shemolduk, let the bride enter their life. As she is a representative of another tribe, she is from another family, from another place. And this same action means her rebirth as a member of this new family, Aul society. If we draw a parallel, then we also cover the dead with a curtain. The soul of the dead goes to the world beyond. So when the bride is hidden beyond shemolduk, and the fact that her face is covered with headscarf during the ritual Betashar, all these rituals signify a rebirth, transition of the bride to another status. She is a new person.
Жест, действие сохранилось, а смысл уже утрачен.
The actions and gesture have been preserved, but the meaning of these rituals has been lost already. And scientists, ethnographers try to disclose them and research for semantics. Such studies lead to surprising results. The origin of some Kazakh rituals and customs goes to the ancient Turkic era. If we talk about the bride who goes to another family, then her face is covered when she leaves her parents' home. Some nations cover the bride's face with a veil. The veil is common for Europe and Russia. The veil is the same as a curtain. I think that there is a principle of mirror shown in this curtain. It's a looking glass. The curtain has the function of transition, function of border.
Переход в тот мир, тот другой мир.
Azerbaijanis, for example, when the bride crosses the threshold of her new home, her husband's home, first bring a mirror into house. That means she enters into another world. Why do people still say that bride should not look back when she is leaving her parents' home?
Не надо оглядываться, когда увозят нее.
Because that world, world of her childhood, world of her father, does not exist figuratively, and it's impossible to look back because it's past.
Невозможно, нельзя смотреть назад, потому что это прошлое.
The bride comes to a new home, a new family. She becomes келин, that is, daughter-in-law, and a new life starts.
Другого рода, другого человека, то есть начинается новая жизнь.
For nomads, the threshold was always endowed with a sacred meaning. It was believed that the threshold symbolizes the border between the external and human world, and it was prohibited to step or stand on it. This action meant to wish evil to the house or bring the family the news of the relative's death. Before entering the house, the future келин had to touch the door lintel with her forehead. The door is a gate from one world to another. Then she had to step over the threshold with her right foot and bow three times to her father-in-law. The relatives who meet the participants of the wedding caravan shower them with shashu, sweets and coins. This is a benevolent ritual. After all guests have gathered, the bride wears beautiful national clothes and stands in front of all with covered face. And the main ritual, Betashar, begins, opening the bride's face. This ritual is arranged by Akin. The singer-improviser introduces the young келин to her new family, starting with her husband's parents. After each verse, the bride makes a bow. In response, her husband's relatives give Kurumdik money to look at the bride. Akin says words of edification and advice how to behave in the new family. Betashar is a moral and ethical code of the Kazakh family. It is a kind of instruction that helps the bride get to know new relatives, learn about the order in the home, simplifies her entry into new family. At the end of the ritual, the singer opens the bride's face with dombra. For the Kazakhs, it is a sacred instrument. Her mother-in-law comes and kisses her, wishes happiness and wealth. The distinctive feature of Betashar is that it is performed only under the song. It is heartening that this tradition is still alive even beyond the territory of the Kazakh steppe.
Обрядовые песни будут жить и живут сейчас.
The ritual songs are alive now and will be alive while the Kazakh nation lives. This means that wherever the Kazakh nation is, maybe in Europe or in Iran or in Uzbekistan, Pakistan, Afghanistan, the Kazakhs perform this ritual. And the meaning of the song Betashar, for example, is the same in our country, in different regions of our country, and among the Kazakhs who do not live in Kazakhstan.
Там уже обжились, живут, они также строго сохраняют.
This ritual refers to the times when our ancestors worshipped the goddess Umai, the goddess of fertility, the mother of all mothers, the protector of the women and children. The image of the Turkic goddess Umai was preserved among the Kazakhs in the form of Mayana, the deity of the family hearth. Yenia, mother-in-law, gives the bride oil and the bride pours it into the fire. During this action, they say Otana, Mayana, Jarulka, Mother of Fire, Mother Umai, bless us. This is an obligatory ritual which is performed when the bride arrives at her new home.
Kazakh'tın dəsturunda kiyeli, kasiyetli.
In the Kazakh language, there are words od, that is fire, and od basi, that is family. The word od also means smoke. What does this mean? This means that a new separate family is started. Tripod and fire are the symbols of this family. The action of pouring oil into the hearth and setting fire is a custom that symbolically means the start of the new family. Umayana is the mother of fire, and the daughter-in-law should perform the ritual of pouring oil into the hearth and setting fire. The woman is a homemaker, it's her duty. After the wedding feast, the bride took saukilya, headdress, off and put the headscarf on. Changing of the headdress means that now she is a married woman. Ethnographers say that in some regions, kilin were an imitation of saukilya until she becomes pregnant.
Ертеңінде енді жаңағы алғашқы түндікті ашып, негізгі қызметіне кірісе бастайды ғой.
The next day, the daughter-in-law arrived her new home. She opened the door of the yurt for the first time and started fulfilling her everyday duties.
Жоралар оңтүстік өңірде көп сақталған ғой. Солардың бірі мына келін шай деп аталады.
This is still followed in the southern regions where many beliefs and customs are still strong. One of these customs is called келін шай. Tea served by келін.
Алыстан келгендері бар. Басқаларың енді келіннің қолынан дәм татайық деген ниетпен мақсатпен келіп, тағы да бір бас қосып той тамақ.
The next day after келін түсіру, people who arrived from afar come to drink tea served by the young daughter-in-law. All relatives gather and continue to feast because this unites people.
Қызмет жасайтын дүние ғой. Алысқа енді ертеңінде аттанатын адамдар бар ғой.
On the other hand, there are guests who need to leave the next day after the toy, so келін шай is a good sign, a kind of ritual дастархан. Usually elder people, mostly women, come to drink tea. After the ritual of drinking tea, they, let's say, apprise the ability of new mistress to prepare tea. They express their gratitude, give gifts, jewelry, sometimes money. This is a kind of blessing.
Жаңағы ықылас батасын беру әзірде атқарылып келе жатқан жақсы салттардың бірі.
The other ritual worth mentioning is the Muslim ritual of the marriage Nikke Kiyar or Nikke Kiyu. Some families invite the mullah, he reads the prayer, asks the newlyweds about consent to marriage in front of witnesses, and then pours out his blessings upon their marriage. At the end of the Kazakh wedding, the ritual Toy Bastar is performed. It is a ritual of gift-giving. In some regions, people sing the ritual song, which is also called Toy Bastar. Toy Bastar is literally translated into English as the beginning of toy, event or celebration, but the ritual is performed at the end of the wedding. It's like a wish to have other celebrations and weddings so that the end of this celebration becomes the beginning of the next. The Kazakhs say Toy Toyra Ulasın, let this celebration flow into another one. And that's why the ritual is performed of the wedding, song Toy Bastar is sang and the gifts are given to the guests. In the old days, a special yurt called otau was set up for the newlyweds. After the wedding, the young kelin rose the first one, opened shanrak in the yurt and began fulfilling her everyday duties because she is a mistress of the family hearth. Much has changed since those days, but some elements of the Kazakh wedding have remained unchanged. The Kazakh village does not exist in the way it used to be, and there are no nomads, wandering people. But most of prairie folkways and traditions still surround us. We follow them, but we not always know what they mean. Бахыт Кайрбеков. poets.